Okay, so let's start the session. I was talking about the importance of mental maths, or in very precise way, mental calculation. See, it's like mental calculation or mental maths not only helpful in a sections of quantitative app, but this is important when it comes to data interpretation. Many a times we have seen a lot of problem which is juggling with a lot of calculation. To deal with that particular question, you need to multiply, divide, finding the percentages. Now you can actually solve that question using a mental calculation. In that case, it will take much lesser time. Better to say, I can say that if you are very much good in your mental calculation, you can precisely save your 4 to 5 minutes of time, in which you can attempt one or two more questions, right? Can help, can create a difference of plus minus 6 marks when you go for an exams like CAT, right? Now, apart from CAT exams, we know that there are lots of exams which are speed test, where the number of questions is very high and the time is very much limited. Like we can take example of IFT, SNAP, NMAT, where the number of questions is literally very high and you have a very limited time. In that case, you need to calculate mentally. A lot of process you need to do mentally, which can reduce the number of steps while calculating, and in that way you will be able to solve much of your time. So basically we have divided this mental calculation class in two parts. The first one is today, in which we'll be dealing with the multiplication. We'll be seeing a lot of things like how we can find a square of 2-digit number, or how we are going to multiply 2-digit numbers fast. So this class basically focus on this kind of calculation. The next class will be dealing with percentages or related calculation related to that. Okay, shall we start, guys? Okay, I'm sharing the sheet, just wait a minute. Is the whiteboard visible? Now, I have divided this particular workshop in 4 to 5 types of calculations and multiplication techniques. We are going to learn it fast, one by one. Now, one thing you just need to take care of, that what we are going to learn today, you need to apply that. You need to practice that. Otherwise, you won't be able to apply this particular calculation in exam in under pressure. I've seen a lot of students, those who know a lot of technique to multiply or to deal with the mental math calculations, but when it comes to exam, they're not able to apply that there and then, just because of the reason they don't have any ample practice. So it's not only important to learn the tactics or learn the techniques, but you need to do practice that particular thing a lot, so that it get into your spine level and you are able to apply that in exam under pressure. Getting a point, guys? So let's start with our first type, which is basically a simplification. Now, what does simplification means? It's like when we are multiplying numbers, right? It will be always on an easier side if we get a numbers which is a multiple of 10. Right. Actually, we just need to add a zero on that. Right. So if I'll ask you that how you're going to multiply 19 into 46. Now, suppose that you are given exam and you need to do this particular calculation. You need to multiply 19 into 46. So there are two options. Basically, three options. The first thing, you do it using a trivial method. Second thing, you can use calculator for this. And the third one, if you know the trick, that how we are going to multiply within a fraction of second. So it's always advisable to go for the third one. Right? Okay, what I'm going to do in this particular question. Now, this thing you need to apply on all the tricks. Like if I'm going to multiply 19 into 46, what I'm going to do is I will multiply 19 into 40, like 46, I rounded off to the nearest numbers, which is multiple of 5, multiple of 10. So it's like a 19 into 4, 76. You can do it mentally, right? And you know that 19 into 6 is like 114. So what you need to do is 760 plus 14, 874 answer. Getting a point, what I'm going to do, what I'm doing over here, like you need to take that particular value in round off it to the multiple of 10. Now you can easily do that. I'm repeating it what I have done, like 19 into 46. What I did is I multiplied 19 into 40, which I can do it mentally, that is 760. Now what I did, 19 into 6, I can find. I know that 19 into 6 is 114. What you need to do is 760 plus 114. Now that is equal to 8. You can do it mentally, right? So let's take another example. Like the first question is 11 into 15. Now what you need to do is 15 into 10 times 150 plus 15 one more time. That is 150 plus 15, 165 is the answer. Getting a point, what I'm doing? That either for question number 3, what you can do, 11 into 23, either you can take 11 into 20 and then add 11 into 3, or you can take 23 into 10 or add 23 once more. Now these are the very basic thing which students generally didn't don't care in types of exams. And I have seen a lot of time that students what they are doing, they are ending up doing 19 into 46. Literally, they used to do 19 into 46, 6 multiplied by 19, they will write, then they'll calculate. And here you will be losing your time, right? So this is the first simplified technique. What I'm going to do, okay, if I'm doing with a dealing with a 2 digits or 3 digits multiplication, generally this particular method is favorable for 2 digits multiplication. Okay, what you need to do, okay, round off to the nearest multiple of 10 and then proceed. You got it? I'm going to repeat that what I've said, that if I need to multiply 19 into 46, what I'm going to do is 19 multiplied by 40. That is 760. Now 19 into 6. Now this thing which I'm writing, you can do it mentally, right? Now add this up. So this will be 870. On a similar fashion, for question number 1, what I said, that if I'm going to deal with 11 into 15, I can do it mentally. 15 into 10, 150. Then 15, one times more, that is 165. I hope you got this method. Okay, what I'm trying to say, everyone. Let's try solving some of them. 3, 5, 7, just for practice set, so that you get it into your spine level and you're able to apply it anytime you want. Question number 3, what are you going to do? 23 into 10, 230 plus 23. Actually, addition you can do it mentally, right? But multiplying the number is that could be a cumbersome task, right? So the answer will be 253. So we move to the next part, guys. Everyone understood this? How we're going to do simplification in terms of multiplication? And now this is the very basic thing which you need to learn, right? From the very beginning. Okay, now let's move into some methods which are going to teach today. Now, type 2, it's like, let's try to understand the types. It says multiplication with same preceding part and sum of the unit digit strength. Now, let's see into the example. Like the first one is 15 into 15. What I'm trying to say, that the sum of the unit digit is 10 in each case. But this is important and this is very helpful sometimes. Like it's like you can even calculate another fraction of second. And the preceding part, which I mean to say, like for question number 11, 1 and 1, this is same. Question number 13. Ruchi, apna audio off kar dijiye, please.
Sorry, sir.
For question number 13, it's the preceding part is same and the 10. Now, what I'm going to do is, for this types of numbers, now it's like you don't, in the initial, when you're going to apply, it could be a possible that you are mugging up the method. But if you keep practicing, after 1 to 2 months, what you'll find that that particular method got into your spine labor and you can apply that there and then as soon as you see the number of that particular type, right? So understood the type, the sum of the unit digit is 10. And preceding digit is same. Now, what you're going to do over here is, like, what you need to do, the step number one, multiply the unit digit with the unit one. So this is like 5 into 5, 25. And for the tens digit, we know that the number is same. Now, what you need to do, you need to increase it by one. That is 1 into 1, you need to do 1 into 2. The preceding number is 1, I increase that by 1. So 1 into 2 is 2 and the answer is 225. Now this particular method I can apply to get the square of numbers ending with 5. Like if I'm asking you, what will be the square of 65? 65 is what? 65 into 65, 65 is square. Like the same thing, the unit digit ends with 10 and the tens digit, the preceding digit is same, right? So what you need to do, that 5 into 5, 25, 6 into 7, 42. What I did, I increased the preceding number by 1, just increase 1, right? Now you can do it mentally. Actually, if a question demands like that, there is a square field given whose side length is 85 units. And suppose that the question deals with the area of that particular square. I have seen a lot of time students doing 85 into 85 calculation and wasting their 30 or 45 seconds. No need to do that. What you need to do? 5 into 5, 25, 8, 9, 72. You can do it mentally, right? Got everyone what I'm going to do? So in this particular method, you learn the process to find the square of a number ending with 5, right? Now, let's try to apply this in multiplication. Like for question number 13, it's like 7 into 3. 21, 2 into 3, 6. Question number 15, 6 into 4, 24, 4 into 5, 20. Getting a point, guys, what I'm doing, multiply the unit digit with the unit digit, write the number like 8 into 2, 16, 8 into 9, 72. Now do it fast, like you can do for the rest of the numbers, right? I'm waiting for the next 30 to 40 seconds. I will definitely know that in the next 30 to 40 seconds you are going to multiply all the numbers possible over. Done, everyone. Interesting one, right? Yes, definitely. You need to go through the condition once again that this multiplication technique is only possible when the sum of the unit digit is 10, and one more condition is there that the sum of the unit digit has to be 10 and the preceding part. Now let's try to understand question number 14. The sum of the unit digit, the unit digits are 4 and 6, right? So the sum is 10. For the preceding digits, the preceding digits are 13 and 13 over here. So that will, this particular process will work in this number. 4 into 1, 46. The unit digit is same, but the preceding digit is 13 and 14. This process won't work. Sharon, got it? Okay, so do it fast. Whatever the number is left, do it fast, guys. Shall we proceed to the next types? Now, actually, what I'm doing is just in this 45 minutes, 50 minutes class, I'll just try to enhance your mental calculation with dealing with different types of methods and numbers, right? So let's proceed to the next type. Now, is it visible? Whiteboard visible, right? Okay. Now let's see type 3, that multiplication with power of 5. Now, what does it mean? Power of 5 means ki if I'm multiplying a number which is either 5 or a power of 5, like if it is 5 square or 5 cube, then what I'm going to do? Now let's see. The trick is very simple. It's like if I'm going to do 42 into 5. Now I'm starting with a very simple example so that you can learn the method, and we are going to apply for the bigger number also. That 42 into 5 is like, I can write 5 as 10 of any number with 10 or the number containing zeros is easy, right? So I can easily divide it 42 by 2, that will be 21, add a 0. Now, like 68 into 5. Now, what I'm going to do again, I can do it mentally, right? 10 upon 2, that is 340. Now, let's see. What I'm going to do is 38 into 5 on a similar fashion. What will be the answer? The process will be, the solving part will be 38 into 10 upon 2. That is one. Okay. Now, actually, you can apply this particular method to solve multiplication of a bigger digits too. Like, suppose that I'm going to multiply some number by 25. Let's take example that 128 into 125. Or first of all, let's take 128 into 25. Now, what I can do is that I can simply write 25 as 100 upon 4. Add the zero. Like I'm just writing to make you explain. You can do this part actually mentally, right? Now, some of you must have questions in your mind, like the digit which I here 128. This is actually divisible by 4. I can do it mentally. What if it is a number which is not divisible by 4? In that case, add 0 first and then divide. So if you'll add 20 at last, you'll be able to divide. At least the process will be faster than the multiplying the number by 25. Give me a point. Example for this particular question, what will be a solving method will be like? You can do it mentally, 100 upon 4. Now, as you know, the 62 is not divisible by 4. So what you can do is 6200 upon 4. Now, dividing a number 6200 by 4 is actually easier. And this will save you at least some seconds if you are going to multiply 62 upon by 25. Getting a point, guys? Now, for 125, like if I'm taking a number which is cube of 5, the method will be same. What I'm going to do is, let's suppose 60 into 125. Now, I'm just giving an example. For this particular number, I can easily multiply 125 by 6 and get the answer. For understanding the process, I'm dealing with this particular example. Like 60 into 125, I can write 125 as 1000 upon 8, right? In most of the cases, there could be a possibility that the number which is given over here is you can easily divide it by 8 and multiply the 1000 by after that. So the thing is, any number or a power of 5, not multiple, power of 5, I can easily write it down as 10 upon 2, 100 upon 4, 1000 upon 8. Now, for that, we can proceed with the calculation wala part. Now, you just don't need to multiply it directly, but write in this format, then multiply, and you'll get the answer. Is it clear, everyone? Okay, again, I'll say this, that whatever types of question I'm making you understand, and just the calculation wala part, that how we're going to do that, you won't be able to apply this in exam until or unless your method get into your spine level. So that you can apply this in exam under pressure. Now you just mug up the method. I have seen a lot of guys learning the lots of Vedic tricks, and definitely they are not going to apply question type when they are under pressure, right? You'll forget everything and you'll start doing the same thing that we are being taught from the childhood days, that multiply it directly. Okay, and exams, some of the exams, like apart from CAT, calculator is not permitted. in some of the exams. So in that case, you need to do it mentally, right? Okay, let's move into the next type of question, that is multiplication using a square minus b square. As we know that a square minus b square can be factorized as a minus b into a plus b, right? So whenever we are dealing with the multiplication, what you're going to do is we just need to factorize the number in this format, a plus b into a minus b. Like, let's take example, if I need to multiply 38 into 42. Again, this type of method, this method will be always helpful for doing multiplication. For that, factorized in this form, which can be represented in form of a plus b into a minus b, right? Like 38 into 42, what again do give 38 can be written as 40 minus 2. Right? Into 42 can be written as 40 plus 2. So now this is again a minus b. 40 can be taken as a, 2 is b. This is a minus b into a plus b, right? Now we know that this is equal to a square minus b square. 40 square, we can easily find out 1600. Subtract 4. So 1596. Got it, guys? Okay, let's take another example. 58 into 60 minus 2 into 60 plus 2. And you can do it mentally, right? That is 60 minus. So we proceed to the next. Understood this one also?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Just give me a minute. Now, is this visible, everyone? Now, let's start with the type 6, then we'll come into the multiplication technique of two digits number. Now, after a lot of time, students, they are mugging up the square value. That it's like this could be possible, like either you make a chart and use to remember the square. But finding a square after learning this technique, you will be able to do that within some seconds. Like, let's take example, and this particular method is you can apply for any square of a two digit number. Like if you remember what I said, that multiplication wala se hum logo ne, what we learn from that particular method is like if a number is ending with 5, right? Like 65 into 65, what I need to do is like 5 into 5, 25, and 6 and 42. So 4225 is the answer. But this is applicable only when the number ends with unit digit, the sum of the unit digit is, and the number preceding is same, will be same for this square, but this is applicable only with the, when the sum of the unit digit is 10. But here you can see that this particular method you can apply in any type of square, finding the square of a two digit number, right? Let's learn this particular method. Now I'll be going slowly to make you understand this particular method, but definitely if you'll practice for 8 to 10 numbers, you'll be able to find the square within seconds, right? Let's take example. The first number, let's take example 59 square. Now let's learn it step by step. Step number one. We can see that it's a two digit number. Now digit at the tens place is 5. Five is 25, right? And the digit at the unit place is 9. Square of 9 is 81. So this is the first step. What you need to do, any number for which the square is being, suppose that 96 square, the first step will be, you need to find the separately the square of the tens and the unit digits given. Like for 9 it is 81, 6, 36. This will be always the first step. First step clear. Now what you need to do is, the second step is, multiply the digits of the number with this power, which is 2. Well, you get 90. Ticket. I'm just spinning step by step by taking time. When you'll practice, you can do it mentally within seconds, right? So step number two is, what you need to do, you need to multiply the digits with 2, which is a in power. So what you'll get? 90. Now what you need to do is step number three. Tens place number, add it over here, and this unit place number you need to add it to the getting a point, guys. I repeat it. First point, find the square of the tens digit. Second point, square of the unit digit. I can do it mentally. Multiply the digits, 5 into 9 into 2, that is 90. The unit digit needs to be added to the tens place of this number. Here it's 0, so it won't be, the tens place numbers won't be affected. Now 25, 9 has to be added to, the tens plus number has to be added to this particular part. So 25 plus 9. And here is 81. So this is the answer. Got it, everyone? Once again, okay, I'm going to repeat it. Let's take different number. Chalo, isi se pehle samajh lo. Let's try to understand from this number only, the example of different number. What I'm going to do, I'm going to take this, this is applicable for the square of two digits number only. if I'm going to find the square of some number, what I'm going to do is step number one, find the square of the tens place. After dictating this particular method, I'll wait for the next 2 to 3 minutes. Okay, you can literally find, actually find the square of some of the numbers to learn this particular. So step number one, square of the tens place number, which is 5, that is 25. Square of the unit place number, unit place is 9, that is 81. Make a consisting of square of tens and plus number. Step number two, you need to multiply the digits. Here the digits of 59 is 5. You need to multiply it by 2, which is the power. Now what you obtain is 5 into 9, 45 into 2, 90. The third step is ki how you're going to add the, this number, particular number. You need to add this number to the step one numbers, which we have already found. Like the unit digit, I'm repeating it, the unit digit needs to be added to the tens place of this number. Here the unit digit is 0. If I'll add to the tens place of this number 8, it won't be affected, right? It will be as it is, 81. This 9 that needs to be added to 25. So 25 plus 9, 34. Now you got that. So you what are the numbers you have? The first part, 34. The second part, 81. Got it, everyone? Understood? Okay. Now let's do with some other number. Now how we are going to do with 96? Now let's take some bigger number and let's try to understand. That if I'm going to find 96 ka square. Step number one, 9 square, you need to find, which is 81. 6 square is 36. We have met the grid like this. This is the first step. Step number two, you need to multiply the digits. Now here the digits are 9, you need to multiply it by 6 into the power, which is 2, which is 108. Now you need to understand one thing over here. In case of bigger number, when you're multiplying the digits and you're obtaining a 3-digit number over here, what you need to do is the process is same. Unit digit is 8. You need to add to the tens place of this number. And this 10 needs to be added to the Now, what you obtain over here is, this will become 91, but 8 plus 3, if you'll add, this will result in a carry, right? This carry needs to be added over here. I repeat it again, what I've done. Step number one, step number two is same. Step number one, finding the square of unit and tens digit number. The 9 square, 81, 6 is 36. I did that. Step number two, multiply it. 9 into 6, 54 into 2, 108. You need to add the unit digit to the tens place. Now adding the unit digit to the tens place of which is 3, it results the number will be 11, right? So I can write 1, 6 is as it is. I can write 1, and 1 is a carry forward. Now the tens place number needs to be added to 81. So this number 81 plus 10 will be 91, and 1 carry forward, that will be 92. Got it? The thing is, like a carry forward, when you add a number in the tens place of a number, tens unit place of a number to the tens place, if there is a carry forward, that has to be shifted. And while multiplying, if we'll get a 3-digit number, just remember that the unit digit has to be added over here, and that other numbers apart from the unit digit has to be added to this particular grid, 81. You got this, guys, everyone? Now this is applicable to any 2-digit number. If you're going to find the square of a 2-digit number, now believe me, while teaching you, I am very slow so that you understand the process. But if you get a command over it, you can able to find the square of any 2-digit number within seconds. You don't need to multiply it each time. Got it, guys? Shall we proceed to the last part? Okay. Now, after each and every types, the last part which is being left is a multiplication technique of 2-digit number. Now, this particular technique which I'm going to explain, this is applicable to the 2-digit number only. Okay. Now, what you need to do is, let's see over here. I'm starting with a very simple example that if you need to multiply 21 into 31, first step number 1, tens place, multiply the tens place with the tens place of the number, that is 2 into 3, 6. Then make a dash, a blank space. Then multiply the unit place with the unit place. Here it's 1, 1 into 1, 1. Now, step 1 clear, guys? What I need to do? Multiply the tens place of the number with the tens place of the other number. Here, the tens place of 21 is 2, 31 is 3. So 2 into 3, that is 6. Now 1 multiplied by 1, the unit place number has to be multiplied. I have written that 1, keeping a space between them. So this is the first step. The second step is, this is clear, guys, everyone? The second step is, what you need to do? Okay, multiply the tens place with the unit place. You can do it mentally, right? 2 into 1 is 2. And the unit place of a number with the tens place, that is 1 into 3. 3. Sum it up and write it down in the middle place, which we have left as a blank space. Now I'm repeating this particular method again orally so that you can get into your head. Like, it's like, okay, what I'm going to do, okay, multiply the tens place with the tens place, write the number, multiply the unit place with the unit place, write the number, then the tens place with the unit place and the unit place with the tens place, sum it up and write in the middle. Now for each and every multiplication, what you need to do is that the step will be same. That first step, tens into tens, then you need to put a gap, then unit into unit place. This is the first step. Second step will be tens into unit and unit into tens, add them, put it into the space. Now there could be a possibility, right? Understand, there could be a possibility ki when you add up the numbers or filling up the unit space, this could result in a carry forward. Like suppose that the number is, the first is 6 and the second is 7. When you add up, you'll get 13. So what you need to do is ke again this 3 you need to fill it up in the blank space, one with the carry forward that has to be added to the preceding number. Got that, everyone? Okay, so this was the 5 to 6 technique and tricks which I have discussed just now. If you're going to apply this rigorously into your method, you'll be able to get this method into your spine level and you'll be able to apply this under pressure. That's all for today's session, guys. See you in the next session of Mental Math. Okay, thank you, everyone.